Hey folks, I'm Rob, and in this quick video I would like to show you how I have created some fan artwork and an animation for Coldplay's new film A Head Full of Dreams. So when the film's director Mat Whitecross posted some cool unused designs for the poster of the film on Instagram, he also asked like if there are any designers out there that might want to give it a try. So as a huge Coldplay fan and a designer that usually works in motion graphics, I really felt like he's talking to me about that. So I thought I'd go for it and give it a try to design something on my own. So I remember the beautiful moments when you're on a concert and the butterfly confetti goes off. You're in the middle of this beautiful confetti with all the lights and the music playing. So I wanted to capture that moment in the poster as a visual as well as an animation. And let me show you how I did this.
So as most of my design processes start in Illustrator or Photoshop, I remembered a font that is called Every True Type is a Wise Font. It's a free font. You can find it on the font, and this is the URL. And a good designer made it. It's available for free. And I saw that there is a butterfly as well as that little bird or pigeon. And as you can see, if you type in the send sign, then you will have that. So you take that. You can type in, for me, it's option and the dollar sign, and then you have that bird. So you can make it larger, and of course you have to create it as paths. So you just change it, and then you get rid of the inside path, and then you have the pigeon. And for the heart shape, I just drew a heart. So maybe something like this. And I select those two shapes, align them, and then select all, go to object, transform, mirror, and copy, and you just push it to the side. You just merge the points, and let's make it a little bit more heart shaped and turn it into fill mode instead of outline. And for the star, we just select the star, we hold down the shift and the option key, then we have this, and then we go to the select tool, and then we just make it a bit more rounded. So we need to level things out so everything is roughly the same size. And there we have our basic shapes. So we save that, and it's important to save this as Illustrator 8. In order to be able to load it into Cinema 4D. And in Cinema 4D, I go to Merge, select my shapes, and here they are. I'm gonna zero those out really quickly to have them in their regular center position. Then what you can do is you can go to Extrude, and you can extrude all of the objects. And all you have to do is make sure that they are not extruded in terms of depth, so it's just like a flat 3D object. Then you hold down C, and then you'll get essentially four shapes. And again, select all, hold down C, and then you have four shapes. So obviously you have to name those. So once we have those laid out, we have to create a shape that will be filled with the actual confetti. So for my first design, I went to the content browser and I used this head. So when loading this head, you will see that it has a lot of things that you can do and you can use it, but essentially I just wanted to use the actual head. So it's only that model, and we go back to our original file. Yes, that's fine. Just paste it, get rid of all the textures that we don't need. And let's make sure the head is in the middle as well. Get rid of all the animation. Get rid of that. So that was my initial idea, to have a head that is full of dreams and full of confetti. To achieve that, you just go ahead and you go to the MoGraph tool and you select the cloner. And in the cloner, you basically you dump in all the things that should be confetti. So let's hide that. And let me show you in Cloner what you can do. You have to choose it to object. And when you choose object, you have to select the object. So the object is the head, obviously. So as you can see now, it's filling this shape. And you have to distribute it as a volume, not the surface. So obviously this is way too few butterfly, and you can crank it up to, let's say, 2000. And now you can see what happens. So now this is filled with confetti, made up of all the different shapes that we have. So essentially it's the bird, the star, the heart, and so on. So this is the draft of what I wanted to create. But everything is very symmetrical, and obviously when you render, you have to make sure that you hide the head. So when you render that, you can only see these parts. And to add some randomness, because you know all the confetti is just this complete chaos, you go to MoGraph effectors, and then you go to random, and then now randomly things are distributed. So if you go to Cloner, you'll see effector is automatically selected, and you can also play with the randomness, and you could animate this, for example. If you go into rotation, then you can also change your rotation values, so you can make them have different rotational values. So again, it looks a bit more natural and not so computer generated. So do something like this, and I like to keep the position pretty much to where it is. You can play with it a little bit just to give it some randomness, but in general this is it. And I think I added a few more here, maybe, I don't know, maybe 5000 or something like this. So yeah, this is looking more like what I had. So this is a quick render without any lights or anything, but this is how this was built. But obviously this is pretty boring because it's black and white, or just white. So you can go to the random, and you can go to, I think, to parameters, color, and you can choose effector color. And now it uses all sorts of colors to colorize it really easily and really simply. So this is how I create that in Cinema 4D. And let me actually show you how you can change this to something else. So let me just take this butterfly and copy it over and make this butterfly quite big. So something like this. And again, give it some more depth as before. So we're gonna select this one, and then we're gonna select the extrude. And we're gonna extrude it out, maybe not that much, maybe just a little, maybe just like this. Okay, so if you look in the back, you will see that it has a hole, so we need to make sure to fill that polygon hole. So now we have a solid volume that we can use to fill it up. So let's go back again and show the face. But instead of choosing the face here, let me just go ahead and move out. And now we're gonna go to Cloner, and see, here is there still a head, so we can choose the butterfly instead of the head. And now we have to make sure that we hide the butterfly itself, so only the polygons of the confetti is showing. So something like this. So yeah, that's maybe a lot. So I think maybe 3K will do. Still a pretty dense volume, and yeah, we can work with this. And this is where the idea was born, to create the animation actually. So you're in the middle of some crazy confetti, and then the camera rotates and moves out, and all of a sudden, oh, you see, it's a butterfly. So yeah, so let me just quickly show you the original file again. So this is how it looks like. Again, I've added a second cloner object, just distributing all the random confetti here around, so it's not so empty. Then this was rendered as a still, and then taken into After Effects. And in After Effects, it's again pretty straightforward. It's usually not a tool to create stills, but animation, and it's my main go-to tool. So what we have here is we have the render. And I've added a little bit of glow, so you can see how things are glowing. I added a little bit of lens blur. And excuse me that I use the German version here, but I think this will do. I also have the alpha channel and the depth channel. to play around with, so I can control a little bit of the look, but I think I just went with the straight render and how it looked like. I actually added three more butterflies close up and gave them some blur, so it will give some more depth. I also retouched three elements out where the text is supposed to be. Then I added a couple of lens flares using Video Copilot's optical flares. It's a bit too strong here. I think I've toned it down and I used some adjustment layers like curves, like giving it like a classical S curve to give it more contrast. And then I used a couple of footage elements that I bought off Motion VFX, and these are in essence some of the motion bouquets and also some dust elements. It's usually called CETA, I heard, which stands for shit in the air. So it's basically just flying around and just giving some atmosphere. So I used, again, the lens blur effect just to give it some nice bouquet effect. This will just add some nice depth, and I think another final layer on top, which is a bit denser here on the top of things. Then again, a little bit of adjustment layers, just messing things up a little bit. And let me quickly walk you through what I'm doing here, and let me go into 100% so you can really see how it looks like. So my usual process is really just adding some chromatic aberration on the edges. This will warp things up a little bit nicely, so it'll give you this just night red, green, blue shift. Then I add some grain with Boris Continuum film grain. Then I add some curves again, just to give it more punch and contrast. And last but not least, I blurred it up slightly with the Gaussian blur by 2 pixels, just to make it a bit more organic and not as sharp. And that's basically it. That's the still. And that still is then taken into Photoshop. So in Photoshop, I load up the image. This is the actual render. And then I'm adding some of the text. I just use the Proxima Nova font. It's a font that's available on the Creative Cloud subscription. And then I also added the title. And it came originally like this. So I extracted that and I created that as a one-liner. And maybe I have to adjust it a little bit so it's not so far off from off. So, but yeah, this would be the title. Make sure it says Coldplay, A Head Full of Dreams, a Mat Whitecross film. And to give it a bit more contrast and to have a little bit better readability is I've added a gradient that is at 50%. So this would be 100% is too strong, but just darken it up a little bit just to give the focus more onto the butterfly itself, but also make the text a bit more readable. I use the same thing for this one. So there's another one that looks like this. I just quickly brushed it on. It's very dimly visible. It's maybe just 30% or something like this. But yeah, so this is how the final poster looks like. Now also let me quickly show you how I've created the actual animation. So let's go back to Cinema 4D really quickly. And it's pretty much the same setup that I have here. And so I've used the cloner again, and everything is based on the butterfly. So the butterfly shape is right there. But when we check it out on how it looks like, you will see that when we move, then this actually is like chaos. It's confetti everywhere. And when the camera moves out, you will start to see that it's actually a butterfly. So the camera pans out. I have two cameras set up. One is the camera for the start, which is in the middle of the confetti. You can see it right here. So this is the camera in the middle of confetti. And then I have a second camera, which is the projection camera. And this one is looking straight on to the confetti, and everything is used with a camera morph setup. So it's morphing between the two cameras and it's creating this beautiful animation. All the keyframes for the animation are within the random effectors. So I have some XYZ and rotational values that are animated, so to give it some spin. So all the butterflies, it looks like it's spinning. And then I rendered out, I think about 250 frames, and I took that into After Effects. And it's, again, the same process as with the poster, very similar. I added some motion blur and depth of field that I've been rendering with Cinema 4D Physical, adding some vignettes, and again, a few flares, just to give it some lighty stage-like look, adding a few elements like dust. And maybe that's interesting on how the type's animated. So for the type, I had the idea of picking up the camera. So as you can see, I have loaded the C4D file in here and I have extracted the camera out of Cinema 4D that I have baked before. So this is the exact same camera that I have in Cinema 4D, and it moves out, so it's recognizing the same movement. So I've offset the title. So in Z space, Dreams I think is further back. Full is like the one that is closest to the actual butterfly. And having this displacement and the fly through gives this little parallax effect that is really nice. Also combined with the depth of field and the blurriness and everything together looks quite sweet, I think. And this is how this animation was created.
Thank you for checking out this video. I hope it helped you or inspired you to try a few things on your own. So thanks again and see you soon.